There are two methods by which you can normally do strength training. We call them eccentric loading and concentric loading. Concentric loading is when you're strengthening the muscle by shortening the muscle with weights. And eccentric loading is when the muscle is getting lengthened and at the same time being trained. Concentric loading is, as I said, when the muscle shortens, it is working on the muscle and therefore training the muscle. But a lot more importance is given by the Czech Institute to eccentric loading, because when the muscle lengthens, especially when you are going to be controlling your movement on lengthening the muscle, you will be giving it a lot more work, and eccentric loading always helps to build a lot more of your muscle mass. So at Maverick, we ensure that when there is a client who is well versed with exercising and he has been exercising for long enough, we give him an eccentric loading kind of pattern so that the tempo is switched, so that the concentric loading is much shorter than the eccentric loading. Let's watch some more tricep exercises where we will be demonstrating one or two tricep exercises which has a lot of eccentric loading in it. We're going to demonstrate the cable tricep push down. As you can see, this is done in a gym environment. Face the high pulley and grasp the cable attachment with the overhand narrow grip. Position the elbows to the side and ensure that you're not moving your elbows. Extend the arms downward and return until the forearm is close to the upper body. Now, normally you would think that when the arm is moving downwards, it is an eccentric thing because it's stretching. But actually, you should remember that this is an exercise for the tricep, and the tricep stretches only when the arm goes upwards. So the movement downwards is a concentric movement, and only the upward movement in this case is an eccentric movement. And there is a lot more work that the muscle gets to do actually during the eccentric movement. So remember, this is a tricep cable push down, and the eccentric loading is only when the arm is moving upwards. Now, this exercise has a very intriguing name, I must say. It's called the barbell skull crusher. I call it intriguing because I'm sure nobody ever wanted their skull to be crushed. So the very name is a misnomer. It is to ensure that your skull is not crushed even when you hold a huge weight right above your face. As you can see, it works on your triceps. And the reason for this very peculiar name is because the hands come straight down to your skull. You're lying on a narrow bench with an overhead grip on the barbell. The barbell is positioned over the shoulders with arms extended. And you lower the bar to the forehead, bending your elbows, and slowly extend your arms upwards. There is a small variation that can be done to this exercise. The exercise can also be performed with the elbow traveling very slightly back. As you are extending, you can travel the elbow a little. Now, this alters the form of the exercise, and the barbell actually moves in a straight line up and down over the forehead, and therefore it works on a different head of the triceps.